In 2017, a cyberattack targeted a petrochemical plant, triggering alarms that could have led to a massive explosion, while in 2021, hackers broke into Florida's water plant and tried to poison the entire city's water supply. These weren't ordinary hacks, they were attacks on SCADA systems, the invisible backbone controlling everything from power grids to nuclear facilities, and in this video, I'll break down what SCADA systems really are, how they are weaponized in a cyber war, and the different ways hackers exploit them, so let's get started. This video is sponsored by Any.Run. Cybersecurity isn't just about knowing how attacks happen, it's also about understanding how a malicious software behaves, and that's where tools like AnyRun come into play. AnyRun is a cloud-based sandbox that helps businesses and professionals analyze how a malware operates by running it in a controlled environment, and rather than relying on delayed reports, it offers some unique advantages, such as delivering actionable results in just 40 seconds for faster threat detection, or featuring AI-driven analysis that helps analysts quickly interpret data and speed up decision-making before threats escalate. Its interface is designed to be beginner-friendly while staying powerful enough for professionals, and includes various tools that let you view all the network connections a malware is making, or the commands it is executing, allowing analysts to investigate threats in real-time with full interactivity. What makes it even better is its teamwork feature, enabling a team to efficiently collaborate in a shared workspace, or the safe browsing tool, which lets you determine the safety of a website within seconds, all while ensuring compliance with SOC and GDPR standards for secure malware analysis. To try it out, you can visit their website and sign up using your university or business email to get the most out of this amazing tool at an unbeatable price. Thanks for listening, let's get back to the video.
Chapter number 1, the key differences between SCADA and traditional IT attacks.
Okay, so starting with the basics, SCADA, or Supervisory Control and Data Acquisition, is basically a term used to describe a combination of both hardware and software to monitor and control industrial processes. These industrial processes may include everything from power grids to oil refineries, or water treatment plants to manufacturing lines, and as a core component of these systems, SCADA ensures that things like valves open when they should, pressure levels stay within limits, and machines operate smoothly without any human intervention. So when we talk about securing SCADA systems, we're not just talking about protecting data. We're basically referring to protecting these complex processes that keep industrial systems running, as if the process goes wrong even a little bit, it can blow up a whole building or put several lives at risk, and this is exactly what makes SCADA hacking different from traditional IT hacking.
Chapter number 2, the hidden weaknesses of SCADA systems.
SCADA systems have been around long before the internet, and that means the protocols they run on were designed for closed or internal networks, which were never meant to be exposed online, making them lack encryption and dangerously easy to exploit. Now you might be wondering, haven't there been advancements in SCADA security, and why are these systems online in the first place? Well, you see, updating older SCADA systems isn't that simple, as that would require upgrading their whole infrastructure, which could cost a fortune, and since most of these systems are owned by private companies, security upgrades often take a backseat because they're just too expensive to justify. But then why don't these companies just disconnect these outdated systems from the internet? Well, because that, too, is expensive and inefficient. Removing SCADA from the internet would mean companies need on-site teams working 24/7 to manually monitor and control everything, which is not just costly, but is also slower and far less efficient than having remote access via the internet. Now don't get me wrong, high-security environments like nuclear plants or military facilities are often completely isolated from the internet, which is why they often remain secure from remote exploitation, but when it actually comes to most industries, such as power grids or oil refineries, fully disconnecting SCADA systems isn't practical, which is why many remain online despite the risks.
Chapter number 3, how hackers exploit SCADA systems.
Now just because SCADA systems have weaknesses, that doesn't mean they're easy to hack, and before I explain why in a bit, you first need to understand that hackers generally use two methods to attack SCADA systems, with the first one being insider attacks. In an insider attack, a hacker generally uses the help of an employee to do something like plugging in a malicious USB directly into a facility's control system in order to compromise or interfere with that system. This type of attack is usually done by intelligence agencies or government entities to target air-gapped or offline industries, and one of the most famous examples of this type of attack was the Stuxnet malware, which was allegedly developed by the US and Israel to sabotage Iran's nuclear program. Once installed, Stuxnet targeted specific industrial control systems that manipulated centrifuges to spin at abnormally high speeds, and ultimately damage Iran's uranium enrichment process, all without the need of physically striking the facility. But here's the catch, developing a malware for SCADA systems isn't as straightforward as creating a virus for regular IT systems. SCADA systems vary greatly between facilities, and an attacker would need to first gather intelligence on the specific setup they're targeting, which may include what PLCs are being used, what protocols are running, and how the facility generally operates. Now the problem with this kind of reconnaissance is that it isn't easy, and usually requires state-level resources for long-term espionage, which makes them far more suited for government-backed cyber cyber warfare rather than individual hackers.
Attack Vector 2, Remote Exploitation.
Now the second method, which can also be carried out by an individual hacker, is attacking SCADA systems which are connected to the internet and indexed on a service like Shodan. If you don't know already, Shodan is a search engine that scans for devices exposed to the internet, and so if a hacker wanted to find SCADA systems, either by using commonly implemented protocols or by a country/region, they could do so using multiple search filters within Shodan, and get hundreds of results based on their requirements. From there, they could try multiple ways to exploit these exposed SCADA systems, but the easiest one would be finding a login page for any one of these systems, and simply keep trying default usernames and passwords until they get the right ones. Once done, they could easily gain access to that specific component of the SCADA system, whether that be an HMI, a PLC, or a remote monitoring workstation. But don't get too excited, as there would be some challenges, with the first being that many SCADA login pages only lead to basic monitoring functions, which require further exploitation to actually gain control, and even if a hacker manages to get that control, they would still need to have a good understanding of SCADA's operations and commands to actually do something. Secondly, even if a hacker is well equipped with SCADA knowledge or has an engineer sitting right next to them, some modern SCADA setups do have intrusion detection systems that flag suspicious activities and disconnect an unknown user from the system. So while SCADA systems and their protocols might be vulnerable, some companies manage to overcome that challenge by securing their networks instead. Anyway guys, so that's it for the video. Before ending, I'd like to state that while I covered the two main ways of attacking SCADA systems, there are still some other methods like performing a supply chain attack in order to hack these systems, but once again that is something which can happen to any company and isn't necessarily SCADA specific. If you have any questions, feel free to ask them in the comment section down below, and I'll see you in the next one.